On my right, we have a function generator. On your right, we have an oscilloscope. Connect the two. And you can observe waveforms like sine, square or noise. Insert between the two a circuit and you can see its response on the oscilloscope. A pure love, a sine story. Well, sorry for being so dramatic, but it's a sad story with two broken hearts. The two might not even need at your lab. Because why do you even need a function generator? This is actually a good question because even the internet says, well, it's complicated. But let's find out. And this is the jewel of function generators, made by AXIOMET, the AX-DG2010AF. It's their most advanced model. It has not one, but two channels with a maximum signal frequency of 10 MHz for sine and rectangle. Moreover, it has a 10 MHz reference signal output and a sampling rate of 125 samples per second. Well, it can output the most common waveforms like sine or pulse, and even has a sweep function to send its love to oscilloscopes. Well, I'm just joking. The best it can do is maybe to send a blink. So now let's take a look at the front panel. Well, right in the middle, you have a button dedicated to switch between the two channels. In order to output the signal, well, you can press the output button, right? Just under, you've got ports which are rated for 50 ohms. For comfortable navigation, you have a sort of a joystick here, okay? In the form of four buttons and a really big knob for ideal steering. I mean, you use those to set frequency, amplitude, offset, etc. Next to the cockpit controls, you have something like a calculator and of course fast function selection buttons here. Although it has a 3.5-inch colored LCD, its overall dimensions make it fit easily on your working desk and it weighs much less than a watermelon, I believe just like 2.5 kilograms. On the right of the display here, you have got some additional buttons for selecting the parameter that you would like to change. On the left, you have a USB port for updating, uploading or saving waveforms and of course, on-off button. Well, checking it from behind, we can see that there are inputs for 10 MHz and modulation and output ports of sync out and triggering and another, a USB port for connecting the device with the computer. Let's be honest for a second. This is a benchtop arbitrary function generator, two channels. You can operate it easily. It has a variety of waveforms with a great frequency range. It can communicate with a PC. It has six different modulations, sweep, burst, and inside of this compact page enclosure, it has 48 different shapes. One of them is even an electrocardiogram. So it's the perfect partner for your oscilloscope. Of course, on the TME website, you will find more information or maybe another candidate. As you know, I do not believe in love at first sight. Coming back to our question, why do you really need a function generator? Maybe going through the different outputs and understanding their true purpose and not just putting something fancy on the display will help. The sine is the basic waveform that the generator can output and can be used for testing filter designs. Here, the maximum frequency is 10 MHz. Sine waves are also used for creating pulses or rectangular waveforms. Those can be used as clocks or synchronization signals for those devices. What is important is how fast the generator can switch between the states. Here, the rise-fall time is defined as less than 12 nanoseconds. The third sort of waveform is the sawtooth or the triangle one. With those, you can control other voltages in systems like analog oscilloscope or test op-amps. The sweep function is a more advanced one. It measures the frequency characteristics of a device using a sine wave that changes its frequency over time. Here we can determine the starting frequency, the ending frequency, select the time period, and make the change linearly or logarithmically. So, do you really need one? As someone said, when you'll need one, you will know about it. So let us know in the comments if you think that those function generators are just too much for your applications.